Here we're going to calculate the excess Gibbs free energy when we're given information about compositions of vapor and liquid in equilibrium, and we're given the saturation pressures for each of the components in a binary mixture. The excess Gibbs free energy, which is some indication of how far the liquid mixture is from ideal. This is calculation for the liquid mixture. Excess Gibbs free energy divided by gas constant and absolute temperature. Mole fraction of component one times the log of the activity coefficient for component one plus the mole fraction component two, the log of the activity coefficient for component two. So the first thing we have to do is calculate the activity coefficients. We're given the mole fractions, and we should, in general, list the information that we're given. So let me do that here. So I've listed the information that we're given in the problem statement, and what we're going to use is modified Raoult's law to get the activity coefficients. This is essentially saying the fugacity in the liquid phase equal to the fugacity in the vapor phase. So this is the partial pressure of component one in the vapor phase, mole fraction times the activity coefficient in the liquid phase times the saturation pressure. And so we can solve for gamma one because we have all the other values. So gamma one in terms of x1, p1 sat. So I'm going to substitute the numbers in. Now, of course, we're going to have the same equation for gamma 2, so we'll calculate that also. So here are the values for gamma 1 and gamma 2. One thing to note, of course, they're dimensionless. Second is they're both greater than 1, and this corresponds to the fact that we have a positive deviation from Raoult's law, namely the pressure is higher than what we predict from Raoult's law. Indeed, the pressure is higher than the saturation pressures of either components, which means at some point in this composition range, we would have an azeotrope. And so now what I'm going to do is substitute the values in. We have x1, gamma 1, x2, and gamma 2. I'll substitute those values in. We'll get the excess Gibbs free energy. So I've made the substitution. Notice I've used gas constant and joules per mole Kelvin. And then I convert it temperature to absolute temperature by adding 273 to the 6 degrees centigrade, and then I reduce it to two significant figures. 1.6 kilojoules per mole is the excess Gibbs free energy for this liquid mixture.